Hello everyone, we have come up with the next section, thermodynamic and rate processes. Here in the part 1 we will discuss the 1 marks question only, because the questions of thermodynamics are more in number, so we will discuss one by one. First we will see 1 marks question only. Which one of the following processes is an example of an electrolytic cell? Okay, the first option is corrosion of a metal rod in ambient atmosphere, charging of a rechargeable battery, discharging of a rechargeable battery, sacrificial anode, cathodic protection of iron. We know about an electrolytic cell, and there is something else called as electrochemical cell, right? So in the case of electrolytic cell, we provide some energy, that is we provide electricity, right? In the case of electrochemical, a chemical reaction takes place which leads to production of electricity. It is what it happens in galvanic cell, right? And here we are providing some amount of energy, and that is leading to a chemical reaction. So what will be the option here? The charging of a rechargeable battery. So what happens, we provide some current and this leads to some kind of reaction in the battery and it charges the battery. In the case of all other cases, there is a chemical reaction which takes place and that produces some amount of current. Okay, so let us move to next question. Which one of the following statement regarding selective leaching of a binary alloy is true? Okay, the lower atomic weight element is leached, the element having higher diffusivity is leached, the more electronegative element is leached, the element with lower density is leached. We need to understand what is a selective leaching. So in the case of selective leaching, suppose it happens in the case of copper zinc alloy. So what happens, the element which has got more affinity, more unstability, so that it tries to combine with some other environments. Suppose some kind of liquid is put over here, then it tries to combine with that liquid. So the element which has got higher electronegativity, so that will try to attract with the foreign element. Okay, so that's why the option will be C, the more electronegative element is leached. Next question. When 1 mole of C3H8 at 300 Kelvin is burnt with a stoichiometric amount of oxygen at 300 Kelvin to form CO2 and H2O, the adiabatic flame temperature is 5975 Kelvin. Okay. If C3H8 is burnt under the same condition but with excess of oxygen, okay, the adiabatic flame temperature will be, so these are the four options, equal to 5975 Kelvin irrespective of the amount of excess oxygen, higher than 5975 Kelvin irrespective of the amount of excess oxygen, lower than 5975 Kelvin irrespective of the amount of excess oxygen, higher or lower depending on the amount of excess oxygen. So guys, here what is the combustion reaction which is taking place? C3H8 plus O2, it is giving CO2 plus H2O. Okay, so this is the reaction which is taking place at temperature of 300 Kelvin. Okay, and this is the 1 mole of C3H8 and it is burned with a stoichiometric amount of O2. So what will be the O2 required here? Now let us balance this one. 3 6 2, so 4 it will be, so 3 6 plus 4 10, right? 6 plus 4 10, so it will be 5. So the reaction will be violent. So for 1 mole of C3H8 we required 5 mole of O2, and this is the stoichiometric amount. If you see the adiabatic flame temperature versus the amount of oxygen to the burning amount ratio, that is the stoichiometric ratio. If the stoichiometric ratio is 1, that means the amount of oxygen which is required for complete combustion of C3H8, the stoichiometric ratio is 1, then That is the point at which we get the maximum flame temperature. That is the adiabatic flame temperature, right? If the oxygen content is low, then the stoichiometric value will be low. Again, the stoichiometric value, if we take higher, then also what happens? The adiabatic flame temperature. This is the temperature, and this is stoichiometric ratio. Okay. So if there is excess amount of oxygen or there is less amount of oxygen, so in both cases what happens, the adiabatic flame temperature will be lower. Okay, so here there is excess of oxygen. Since there is excess of oxygen, so this will act as basically coolant, you know, coolant. It will try to decrease the temperature. If there is less amount of oxygen, that's why the enough combustion is not taking place and we are not getting sufficient amount of energy liberated. So that's why we are getting the less adiabatic flame temperature in that case also. Okay, so oxygen will be lower than 5975 irrespective of the amount of excess oxygen. Like whatever the amount of excess oxygen let it be, there will be the temperatures will be lower. Okay. Next question. Two solid spheres X and Y. Okay, X and Y of identical diameter are made of different material. The diameter is same, right? Having thermal diffusivity 100 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second, and this is 25 into 10 power minus 6. So here in the case of X it is 100 10 power minus 6, right? In the case of Y it is 25 into 10 power minus 6. Both spheres are heated in a furnace maintained at 1000 degrees centigrade. Sorry, 1000 Kelvin. If the center of the sphere X, okay, reaches 800 Kelvin in 1 hour, time required for the center of sphere Y to reach 800K. So here also we need to reach 800K and the outside temperature is 1000K, right? But in the both cases the diffusivity is different. So what will be the time required to reach in the case of Y? If the time it is taking in the case of X is 1 hour, okay, so we know that in case of this diffusion there is a term dt is equal to constant. Diffusivity into the time is constant, so you remember this one. So this will be the formula which will be used. So in the case of X it will be diffusivity 100 10 power minus 6 into time required is 1 hour. In the case of Y, diffusivity 25 into 10 power minus 6 into time required. That's related with T. So if you divide, so T is nothing but 4 hour. So answer will be 4 hour. So for this problem, you remember dT is equal to constant. Okay. Next question. Select the correct spectra shown on the log-log scale in the figures for emission from a gray surface and a black body, both maintained at 1000 degrees, 1000 Kelvin. Okay. You know about a black body, right? Black body is a dead body which liberates all amount of energy, all energy, or it accepts all radiation. Okay, and a gray body, it absorbs some wavelength and plus reflects also. Okay, it liberates some amount of energy and not liberated other energy. So basically black body is one which absorbs all the radiation which falls on it. In the case of gray body it is not so. So when it will try to emit radiation, so you know about this spectral emissive power, that is emissive power is directly proportional to emissivity constant. Boltzmann constant and temperature to the power 4. Okay, so for emissivity for black body it is 1. Okay, and emissivity for gray body it is less than 1. So since the emissivity value for a gray body is less than 1 and temperature is constant and Stefan-Boltzmann constant is also a constant, so the energy of a gray body which is liberating will be lower as compared to the black body. So where is this option? You can see here the option, in the option A is also there, in the option D is also there. You see here option A and option D, but in the case of option A there is a fluctuation, you know, fluctuation in the graph, there a drop and this, so these things do not happen. So basically the option D will be the correct answer. Okay, so you remember here that emissivity of a gray body is lower than black body. Okay, now let us move to next question. An iron plate with a total exposed surface area of 50 cm square undergoes atmospheric corrosion. If 200 gram of weight is lost over a period of 10 years, the corrosion rate is, and the corrosion rate we have to find in kg per meter square per year. So guys, here all the values you did take from this equation, that is what is the area over here, it is 50 cm square and 200 gram is lost over a period of 10 years. Okay, so corrosion rate is weight loss per unit area per unit time, right? So 200 grams, convert it into kg, right? Area is 50 cm square, so you also convert it into meter square, 10 power 4 minus 4 into time, we have to find in year only, so let it be 10. Okay, so the answer will be 4 kg per meter square per year. Right guys, so this is a simple problem where all the values are given here, so we just need to find the corrosion rate with the help of weight loss per unit area per unit time.